Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Monday, June 7th, 2010. In the pre-market on Monday morning, coming up to 7 a.m., we've got futures just slightly above fair value. Both gold and crude oil are down slightly on Monday morning. So a much quieter open Monday morning than we saw on Friday. Start off this morning taking a look at a couple of weekly charts. For the TSX, we're on our fifth week of a weekly downtrend, so the pressure and the bias is still to the downside. For the markets overall, we're looking at our sixth week of a weekly uptrend for the VIX. With the VIX continuing to be in a weekly uptrend, we expect more volatile, wide-range days to be the norm and not the exception. Taking a look at a daily chart for the TSX, we're sitting right at the 200-day moving average for the TSX. Some of the U.S. indexes are below the the 200-day moving average and using that as resistance at the present time. And so that's a bit of a concern for a lot of people who watch these moving averages as indicators of major bias in the stock market. The TSX did punch through the 200-day moving average, came back, and has been using it as support for the last couple of days. Looking at the U.S. dollar, it continues to remain in a bull market and coming up to a major area of resistance. You can see there on the left that we had a major peak and then a sell-off and a major move to the downside. And so we're coming up to that inflection point. Not sure if we have enough energy left to make it there, but that would be the goal for the market at the present time. Looking at copper, it broke down below the 2010 low. That is certainly not a good sign for the global economy overall. Natural gas broke out of its range last week, and that's good for those of us with a bullish bias to natural gas. Natural gas moved up, certainly not enough to get the attention of long-term investors. We see the weekly conservative chart is still in a downtrend. We see that the Is It Safe chart is telling us it's still not safe to be in natural gas. And those are two conservative views of the natural gas market, and it would be nice to see those both turn around over the next couple of weeks. Moving forward, looking at daily charts for the TSX, we generated a buy signal on Wednesday. It was a really weak buy signal. We only closed a couple of points above the upper channel line. We're kind of suspicious of that. We came down sharply on Friday, closed below the lower channel line. We're having wide range days. Hey, the VIX is very high at the moment, so we expect those wide range days. So we're on a sell signal. We need a daily close above 11,762 on Monday to give us a buy signal. We're on a buy signal for energy stocks. A daily close below 275.79 would generate a sell signal on Monday. For bank stocks, we're looking for a daily close above 180.24 to generate a buy signal. Bank stocks came down and are testing support at the present time. Be interesting to see if that support holds on Monday. Looking at gold stocks, we're looking for a daily close above 366.11 to give us a buy signal. For material stocks, we're looking for a daily close above 338.24 to generate a buy signal. And for the venture exchange, we're looking for a daily close above 1504.41 to give us a buy signal. Looking at the U.S. dollar, made a new high on Friday. A daily close below 86.24 would give us a sell signal on Monday. Canadian dollar sitting right on a sell signal. Any lower close on Monday would generate a sell signal. For copper, broke down, made a new low on Friday. A daily close above 367 on Monday would generate a buy signal. For gold, we're still on a buy signal. A daily close below 1208.94 would generate a sell signal on Monday. For crude oil, we needed a daily close above 73.14 on Monday to generate a buy signal. And for natural gas, we broke out on Thursday, moved a little higher on Friday, and we're certainly out of that range that we were concerned about that started in early April. Looking at some new sell signals as of Friday's close, just a couple of stocks, didn't really get any buy signals on Friday. So we've got Brookfield, We've got Power Corp. We've got Manulife. We've got Inmint Mining. And Tech all generated sell signals as of Friday's close. These are stocks in the TSX 60s that I watch. Taking a look at some of the Horizon Beta Pro ETFs that I follow. For the energy bull, we need a daily close below 669 on Monday to give us a sell signal. For the financial bear, we're up testing previous highs. We need a daily close below 919 to give us a sell signal. You'll see we came up, filled the open gap, and have not been able to break through since then. So while the TSX Financial Services Index is looking at support, we're looking at resistance for this particular ETF. Moving on, looking at the gold sector, these are gold stocks. We don't have a buy signal for the bear. We need a daily close above 1409. At the same time, we don't have a buy signal for the bull. We're looking for a daily close above 14 to generate a buy signal for this ETF. Looking at the TSX bull, we're looking for a daily close above 1783 to give us a buy signal. We're now on a sell signal as of Friday's close. At the same time, we don't have a buy signal for the bear just yet. We're looking for a daily close above 1243 on Monday to generate a new daily buy signal for the TSX 60 bear. Looking at the 60-minute charts for Monday's trading activity, we can remain bearish on the TSX as long as we remain below the 11,709 area. For energy stocks, we can remain bullish as long as we continue to trade below 287.78. For financial stocks, we can remain bearish on Monday as long as we continue to trade below 177.07. For gold stocks, we can remain bullish as long as we continue to trade above 358.71. And for material stocks, we can remain bearish as long as we continue to trade below 331.42 on Monday. Okay, that's all for Monday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.